people will conduct conversations entirely around things that you kind of know neither person really knows about, but it's what you're supposed to be talking about.
How you doing?
You have to have an opinion on Syria. Yeah, it's rough, it's bad. I don't know what we're gonna do. Obama. Just like say Obama like 7 times and you'll probably be good.
I wanna be your manager.
So, a good strategy, in addition to everything that I just described, is to acknowledge the fallacy that is your interaction. You talk about Syria, bring up Syria, but maybe, you know, acknowledge the fact that I'm supposed to know about this. I don't know anything about this. Am I doing something wrong? Am I failing as a human being? Are we both failing as a human being? And once you, if you establish that connection with someone, then you're pretty good for at least 2 years. I think that's the amount of time that people's lives remain the same. You might outgrow your like for Seth Rogen within 2 years. You know, I used to think Seth Rogen was great. Now he's like pretty good. In 3 years, I won't like him at all. We just reassess everything, basically, every 2 years. Become a new person. Buy new clothes, turn into a hipster if you were like a bro. I'm in the process of doing that, so I think Joe is as well. I think the ultimate stamp on a long-lasting adult friendship is being invited to their wedding. You know, that's basically like, you are worthy of the biggest moment event of my life. I think your role is just, it's like being a member of any team. You gotta find your role, you find your role quickly, and you figure out what you could do to contribute, and then maybe the coach likes you. Is there even any coach? If the guy treats you like shit at your wedding, then make sure to do the same thing. It's like a weapon. Make sure you could always have weapons to use against. That sounds bad. That sounds like you're just trying to manipulate people. But maybe that's just what friendship is. When